So with the conclusion of the men's singles, and Naren Liu is maiden victory, our attention now turns to women's singles. The number one seed from India, Saina Nehwal, looking for her second title in 2 weeks. She's up against the unseeded Minatsu Mitani of Japan.
Allez, on est reparti pour accueillir dans quelques instants donc, la troisième finale des concerts. Vous avez le programme de bien concerne les dames en simple. Et nous les accueillons dans quelques instants.
To the women's singles final. Becoming a regular occurrence for the number one seed, Saina Nehwal. This is her fifth final of the year. And of her previous four finals, she has a 100% record. She's won all four of them. Seven different nations represented there, two Japanese girls as you can see, and they went through to the semi-final. The top half of the draw, the semi-final encounter, a repeat of the final from the Denmark Open last week. It's with Itani being a more experienced teammate, Hirose. The world number three, up one place in the world ranking since last week. She has been as high as two in the world, but as you can see from her win-loss record for the year, four previous finals, four previous titles. This is a wonderful run. This is her fourth final in the last five tournaments. So to the 21-year-old from Japan, from Ishikawa, up to a career-high 26 in the world. Not seeded, of course, because her ranking wasn't high enough. And this, her first final of the year. Prior to this,
ladies,
the previous best was a semi-final at the Swiss Grand Prix. That was an interesting spectator. Fabrice Vallée, the team's manager of the French badminton team. bronze medalist, of course, Simon Nawal, in the recent Olympic Games. Between the two, and it's done in what was last week in the second round of the Denmark Open. Two straight games it was, 21-15.
Ladies and gentlemen,
14.
On my right, Minatsu Minati, Japan.
And,
and on my left, Sanya Nehwal, India.
And our service judge.
Saina Nehwal to serve. Lovell, play.
So the number one seed from India, Saina Nehwal, far side of the court. The unseeded Minatsu.
One love.
Japan, her opponent. And here today at the French Open, history is being made because of the five previous French Opens that have been part of the Super Series.
One all.
Previous women's singles titles have gone to a Chinese player. This will be the first time that a Chinese player has not even been represented in the final.
Ready, sir? 2-1.
Well, when you've reached your fourth final in five tournaments played, last five tournaments played, as Simon Nehwal has, you know the player is in good form. One of her last five tournaments that she didn't reach the final was, of course, the Olympic Games, where she was bronze medalist.
Very silver. 2-0.
Tani. Has been growing in confidence. Every time I see her play, she seems to play better and better. Example in that rally of the court
three,
coverage of
two.
Mitani. Extraordinary to think that prior to this French Open, this Japanese player had never progressed past the quarter final of a Super Series tournament, and she only achieved that once. That was at the China Masters earlier this year. Tani, she's had a great tournament. In the very first round, she beat the number six seed, Jiang Yang Jiao of China. Then Kasuma Stuti of Indonesia, quarterfinal against the European champion, Tina Bound. Two straight games there. All of her matches, in fact, in two straight games. Yesterday's semi-final against Iriko Hiroshi, her teammate. Hiroshi, of course, had beaten the number two seed, Wang Shoshian, in the second round.
3-4.
She put together a great set of results as a young Japanese player.
Very forward. 5-3.
Already once. 6 Super Series titles as this lady, including 2 Premier Super Series. Oh, that's good defence. Lovely defence from Natani.
4-6.
Extraordinary to think that this is the Japanese player's first appearance at the French Open.
That is over. Oh, sorry, correction.
Yeah, correction on part.
Sorry, correction.
Yeah, it was called long. It is actually 5-6.
5-6. That is over.
Good reverse angle on the smash.
7-5.
Oh, that's clever. Very nice. Took the shuttle early at the front of the court. Held it to the last moment, flicked it over Newell's head.
Seven all.
Oh, she's back to Newell. Good use of the body smash there, body attack, having played out wide.
8
Next
all.
Smash, right at Natani. Yeah, she was wearing that knee bandage last week as well. Coverage is incredible, Natani.
9-4.
Full stretch.
10-9.
Hasina Nawal is so tactically astute. Very, very clever player.
Denisova. 10-0.
So this next point will decide who has the advantage at the mid-game interval. Oh, so too is that.
11, 10,
goodness gracious, where did that suddenly come from? Wonderful shot from Minatsu Mitani. Slicing across the feathers. And it's the Japanese player who has the 1 point advantage. Indrawan, talking to Simon Abel. And mentor Pinar Gokchan. I was saying yesterday he was probably in Japan with the national junior team, but I've been reading in the Indian newspapers today that in fact he's not gone to India because the top
seconds.
Two junior players both struggling with injury and therefore not at the World Junior Championships, and therefore Pinar Gokchan has stayed at home in Hyderabad to prepare his players for the upcoming China and Hong Kong Super Series events.
11, 10, play.
Watch her movement around the court. Yeah. No center of gravity as she moves.
13, 10.
Bent legs in a crouch position. Change of direction. Lovely mover. Not the tallest of athletes, 161, that's just not a 5'4". Oh, that's magnificent.
And over.
I understand, no. What a smash from Simon Awell.
11, 13.
What a good mover Nawal is, but in comparison to Mitani, looks a little bit laboured. Once again, good judgment on Mitani.
14-11.
Good pressure from Simon Mayer putting her opponent at the back of the court, and that took courage because she's had a couple
14.
Long.
Thank you.
Well, the pressure from Simon Nadal is relentless.
13-14.
And Tony just running out of ideas there. Problems when your opponent is such a good retriever of the shuttle. Feel you've got to hit the lines for it to be a winner. And in trying to go for the lines, that's when you start making errors. Oh, it's long. Missed opportunity. She knows it.
14-15.
Incredible defense, isn't it? Got it back. And indeed won the rally. That is incredible retrieving. What happened again so quickly?
15-14.
Singles becoming more and more like men's singles. Every tournament, the athletes just as much agility and speed. We're seeing just as many dives nowadays as well from women. Deep forehand, deep backhand, then brought the Japanese player into the net.
15,
and finished
15.
It off with a smash, having got her out of position. Clever, clever play from Simon Ewell.
Come on.
Back level. Hesitation. I think it may have landed out, but it was awfully close. Held the shot to the last moment there in favour of the call of punch clear. And held it to great effect. So three straight points and into the lead now. It's definitely going wide, yeah. Four straight points.
18-16.
It's Pierre Millien, former French number one in singles play. Retired after the London Olympics.
That is over. 17-18.
Come on, Simon! What a pity.
And so it ended with an error.
Both players really pushed and extended by their opponent. And the frustration with the final error from Mitani.
That is over.
Well, he didn't seem to be fully committed coming forward there. And the injury on the right knee was a contributing factor to that. From Ninatsu Mitani, and she's earned herself a game point. That's gone long. The youngster from Japan has upset the form book in game number one, which she takes against the number one seed, Simon Awa.
21-19.
21-19 confirms the umpire.
Twenty seconds.
Well, what a turn up in the opening game there.
Second game.
Ninatsu Mitani.
Bravo.
Play number one against the number one seed, Simon Awa. 21-19.
It's over. 1-0.
It's now in the center of the year.
He might try and...
2-1.
You might see Simon Ewell trying to up the intensity.
They are.
Make a big effort to try and take the shuttle a little earlier. Yeah, look at that.
3-1.
Looking for angles. Angles can be created by how you take the shuttle.
And it's over. 2-3.
The pressure once again showing of when you know your opponent is so good at retrieving the shuttle. They're trying to make it too tight to the net for a drop shot.
Game is over.
Come on, I'll go again.
6-3.
Sense that perhaps the momentum of this match has changed. Yeah, a little bit of frustration showing with Mitani. And Simon Ewell looking calm as and collected as ever. A super point. Well constructed by Mitani.
4-7.
Suda.
Rally of the match so far. And in the end, it was a superb reverse slice cross-court drop shot from Mitani that did the damage.
Look at that. Sent Ewell in the wrong direction.
Yeah.
Oh, it's going wide. That's another very grueling rally. It's physical toll. Oh, she's been promising for so long, has Mitani. Over the last year, she's been former world number one, Wang Sim, former world champion Wang Lin. In fact, two victories over her. She's beaten Wang Shuxian and Zhang Yang Xiao. Never followed it through to the final of a major tournament. So I know she can beat the best players. And with shots like that, it's clear to understand why and how she's managed to beat those top Chinese players.
Seven, eight. It's over.
Yeah, go.
9-7.
Bella, bye.
That is over.
Well, I thought in the early stages of this second game, Sina Nehwal was looking as if she really settled, as if she was in command. And she led 7-3. But since then, at times she looks a little unsure. Yeah, mishit there in that rally. And all of a sudden, her opponent's back level.
9-0. And it's over. 10-9. And it's over. 10-0.
Point in it at the mid-game interval. Game this is the Japanese player who has the advantage. How on earth did she get that back?
Twenty seconds. Eleven, ten, play.
So play resumes here in the second game. He knew that history would be made today, never before at the French Open. He's trying not to take the women's singles title. But I can't help but wonder if more history is going to be created, because never before in the history of the Super Series has a Japanese player won the women's singles title. Yaka Sato, of course, was beaten finalist in the Indonesia Super Series event, lost in the final of 2010 to this lady, Saina Nawal.
13-10.
Rupa Hirose has been in two finals. All England Championship last year, and of course the recent Japan Open as well.
Ten.
She's had an awful lot of badminton over the last 2 weeks, as this young lady. I wonder if it's beginning to catch up with her. Well taken. Well, it's a run of 15, six straight 10. Points. Remember, she was 9-10 down. Only just, but a good call from the line judge. Oh, that's been a set.
It's over. 15-11.
Yep, once again, a good call. Of the last 9 points going in favour of Minatsu Itani. Wow.
18-11.
It looks to me as if history is about to be made. Not only reaching the drop shots, but then playing the perfect net shot.
19-11.
2 points away from the title. Oh, that's landed in. Oh, this is absolutely extraordinary. 11 of the last 12 points. Going in favour.
20 match point 11.
9 match point opportunities.
Yeah.
And she takes it. The first ever Japanese winning singles player to win a Super Series title. Minatsu Itani has beaten the world number three, the number one seed, Saina Nawal, here in the final of the Yonex French Open.
Minatsu Itani, 21-19, 21-11.
12 of the last 13 points from 9-10 down in this second game. It was all one-way traffic and it was all in favour of Minatsu Itani. Well, she's never even won a Grand Prix title before, her three previous titles have all been International Challenger events. Today in her fifth ever final, her first Super Series final. And she's taken one giant leap as far as her career is concerned. Her maiden Super Series title, and she did it in fine style. Once again, confirmation of the score, 21-19, 21-11. And Mitani is winner of the Yonex French Open. So much, and it delivered so much. Some wonderful, wonderful rallies, and the retrieving ability of Minatsu Mitani was something to behold.